And a very good morning to you. It is Tuesday morning, the 21st of December, the year 2021. And this is your friend, Angus Buchan, with a thought for the day. If we go to the book of Exodus, right in the beginning of the Bible, Exodus chapter 20, verse 17, you shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, nor his male servant, nor his female servant, nor his ox, nor his donkey, nor anything that is your neighbor's. And then we go right across to the book of Acts, chapter 20, and I am reading verse 33. This is Paul speaking. He says, I have coveted no one's silver or gold or apparel. Yes, you yourselves know that these hands have provided for my necessities and for those who are with me. The word covet means yearn to possess something belonging to someone else. Now, Jesus says that if you desire to follow him, you are to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow after him. Mark chapter 8 and verse 34. So often we look at the cross that our neighbor carries and we covet it. Oh, he's got a much easier walk, Lord. I would really love to have what he has. Or he has got such a wonderful business or a farm or whatever it might be. I heard a wonderful story long time ago that Jesus, you know, he's a carpenter and he's the one who's in the carpenter shop making a cross to fit every single one of us, especially fitted for our size. But this man didn't like his cross, so he went, it was very uncomfortable, so he went and he put it down on a heap of other crosses and he decided to choose another one. So he looked and he saw a beautiful cross adorned with the most beautiful roses. He picked it up. It was full of thorns. But soon as he picked it up, the thorns, they stuck into his hands. So he put the cross down very quickly. He looked around and he found another cross, a magnificent cross made out of pure solid gold. But when he picked up this cross, it was so heavy, he could hardly put it on his shoulder. So he put that one down. And then he looked around and then he found an ordinary, plain, wooden cross. Smooth, not too heavy, fitted exactly into his shoulder. And he decided that this was the one that he wanted. Only to find out that was the very one he had put down. You know, 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 6 says, godliness with contentment is great gain. Just be content with your lot in life and thank Jesus for every day. God bless you and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.